Hello, and happy December. A couple of years ago, the guys sat down and we discussed a couple of Christmas topics. And since we're all about recycling bits, we're going to release those for a couple of days this week. So if you have not listened to these, please enjoy. If you have, listen to them again. And here's some classic audio from your friends at How Many. And oh, by the way, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Happy Kwanzaa, and don't forget Festivus, the holiday for the rest of us.
Sam! Oh my God!
What we're looking for today is the Griswold family Christmas tree.
You can see her nipples.
I want to see her nipples.
Mr. Grinch, I came to invite you to be Holiday Cheermeister.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Grinch.
Name? Kris Kringle.
Bye, Dad!
Merry Christmas to all! To all a good night!
Looks like a Christmas tree.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
My dad works there.
Empire State Building.
I hope I never see any jerks again.
I made my family disappear.
Where do you think you're going to put a tree that big? Bend over and I'll show you.
See, kids, it means something different to everybody. Now I know what it means to me.
Would you please tell her that you're not really Santa Claus?
Well, I'm sorry to disagree with you, Mrs. Walker, but not only is there such a person, but here I am to prove it. I'm Santa Claus. Oh, you don't believe that, do you?
Mm-mm. Your Honor, the state of New York concedes the existence of Santa Claus.
I believe. It's silly, but I believe.
My name is Scrooge. I shall never forget the lessons that they teach. Tell me that this will change my future. To all of us, everywhere. A Merry Christmas to us all, my dears.
No, shoot your eye out.
You shoot your eye out?
You shoot your eye out, kid.
Oh my God, I shot my eye out.
That Christmas would live in our memories as the Christmas when we were introduced to Chinese turkey.
There's something in the wind today that's good for everyone.
Yeah.
You believe in Santa Claus?
For some reason, I knew that this question was going to come up.
Dad, how do you spell hallelujah?
How should I know? What do you think I am, a dictionary? Tommy, stop that. Stop it.
Look, who are you?
I told you, George, I'm your guardian angel.
Yeah, I know. You told me that.
Look, Daddy, teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings.
How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Hoo, hoo, hee, ho, fa, hee, 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 ha.
All right, what did I get up to?
All right, welcome to another holiday episode of How Many, your podcast all about four guys talking holiday stuff. I am one of your hosts, Jesse Jackson. Joining me today is...
Mexican Jr.
Scott Matua.
Bob Lamb.
And we have a quick one today. We've already talked about animated specials. We've talked about...
Christmas songs.
Christmas songs. And now we're going to talk about Christmas movies. So the premise is... These are movies, not necessarily the Hallmark movies. These are movies that were in the theater, or a couple cases, classic animated episodes. So we're going to try to go through this quick, but I'll be home for Christmas.
Wait, do we need to give a number?
Oh, I guess yes. Okay.
I have
100 Christmas movies here. How many do you actually think are good movies, not good Christmas movies.
Are we
good
counting
movies.
Non-traditional?
Yes.
So like,
yes.
Die Hard.
Die Hard.
Okay, I will go 30. Okay.
Damn it.
So is that your number?
I was going to go 30, but that's
Scott,
okay.
Okay, you could do, yeah, you could do 30.
I'll go 31.
Nice.
All right, Bob?
I'll go 25.
All right, and I, probably will, the cinema, so I'm going to do 40, but I have not done any research except printed off on IMDb. All right, so our first choice is Kirk Cameron, I'll Be Home for Christmas.
Out.
Yes.
Anything Kirk Cameron, immediate.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
The Wonderful World of Disney, Santa Who.
No.
Out.
Okay. Jack Frost with Michael Keaton.
I think we discussed that. No, you're talking about the movie where he's a snowman.
Yeah, yeah, he's a snowman.
Snowman.
Right. I never saw it.
All right.
I've seen it a few times.
It's an okay movie. It's a nice
okay.
hug or heart tugger.
Okay.
But I wouldn't seek it out.
Okay. Eight Crazy Nights.
The Adam Sandler movie.
It's a Hanukkah movie.
I never saw that. And it's a cartoon.
Yeah, it's a cartoon, yeah.
I never saw
Chonica.
It.
Okay.
Or Chonica.
Anybody else?
No, I've never seen it. It's not one of
those. Doesn't Kiss do the theme song for that one?
Oh.
Crazy, crazy, crazy.
Ultimate Christmas Present, starring Holly Hirsch. Yeah.
No.
Okay.
No.
All I Want for Christmas with, I don't know anyone
no.
on this. Winter Wonderland. Another Cyber League, don't know anyone. Christmas Mail.
No.
You sure you're not hitting Hallmark movies there?
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Maybe. Grandpa for Christmas. Yeah, this is a TV movie.
Out.
No.
Christmas Shoes.
Oh,
that's
no.
With the Rob.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Christmas Shoes.
That's not that song.
Yeah.
I've never even heard of it.
Yes, some of these are TV movies.
Yeah.
Season for Miracles, and actually is one of my favorites. It has our favorite, Carla...
Gino
playing a homeless family, but yeah.
I've seen that one, but
yeah.
I'm out.
Okay.
It's a Hallmark, I'm not.
Okay. Then I'm going to skip some of these and go to Christmas Eve. That's, you know, that Patrick Stewart, James Rhoda, this is one of those where it's a holiday-themed movie and they all have the different stories that's kind of gone through.
Kind of like the Gary Marshall movies, like...
Yeah, yeah, Mother's
New
Year's
Day
and New Year's
Day.
Yeah.
Not
no, I'm out.
Okay.
Out.
All right.
I meant to alter my number now.
Yeah. Four Christmases.
Yes.
The Vince Vaughn and Reese...
That's,
I like that movie.
That's good.
Vince Vaughn.
That's when they buy the Xbox and the family gets all pissed off about
it's
it.
It's a satellite.
Yes. How about Reindeer Games with Ben Affleck and
Charlize
Theron? Yes.
Isn't that like a shoot 'em up movie?
Yes.
It is,
yes.
But it was based on Christmas.
Yeah, around Christmas.
I didn't think it was that great.
Okay.
I thought it was okay. I don't. I could be talked out of it.
Okay.
I'm not into it.
I'm skipping all the movies, so we may have to do... A Friday After Next, they say.
That's
the
a Christmas
movie?
Movie?
Yes.
I know.
When they're
first Friday.
You understand the man slapped.
That's Rush
Hour.
That's Rush Hour. First Friday or GTA.
How about Mixed Nuts with Steve Martin?
I know about these nuts, but I don't
yeah,
know.
Yeah, Steve Martin and Madeline Kahn. Okay.
Mixed Nuts.
All right. Frosty the Snowman is a TV short.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that counts.
Okay. All right. I do not remember this. In 2009, Nativity, an improvised comedy based around a school nativity play.
Is that the one where Larry
with
David gets
Freeman.
Stuck in his throat? Fights with the...
No.
Okay. How about Nicolas Cage's Trapped in Paradise? They play the brothers.
Oh, wasn't John Lovitz and Dana Carvey?
Yeah, John Lovitz and Dana
Carvey,
yes.
I don't know that.
Not a bad movie, but I don't think I'd count it. A Very Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas?
We saw that in the theater.
And
I liked it.
There was a lot of good Neil Patrick Harris shit.
Okay,
yeah.
So,
especially with
any of that?
Who was the Asian guy that gets hit with an egg or something in slow motion? Because it was a 3D, right? So,
yeah.
Because he takes a bullet for Kumar or something
A
like
classic,
that.
The Lemon Drop Kid. This was
yes.
Bob Hope. And this is where Silver Bells came from.
That is the first movie with Silver Bells.
Not familiar, but that is one I've heard of the masses on that one.
I've tried to find that on DVD widescreen for years. It is classic, yes.
Okay. Beyond Tomorrow, 1940s movie, the ghost of three elderly industrialists killed in an airplane crash returned to Earth to help reunite a young couple whom they initially brought together with Harry Carey, C. Aubrey Smith.
I don't know that one.
Okay. One Magic Christmas, that was with Mary Steenburgen.
I love that one. Okay. Because it has the great Harry Dean Stanton who plays the angel in that one. His name
is.
Yes.
I'm not familiar.
He plays a cowboy angel who comes in.
I'll defer to the masses on that one.
All right. Christmas with the Cranks.
That's the one with Tim Allen and Jamie Lee Curtis.
Right.
And that's the one where they go to like, they were trying to go to like some summer vacation place.
And don't they fight Sinbad and Schwarzenegger for toys at the department store?
No, it's a totally different movie.
Totally different movie.
I think they're like fighting with Dan Aykroyd or something, like their neighbors or something like
Tim
that.
Allen,
no,
Tim
that was neighbors.
Dan Aykroyd, Emmett Walsh.
No, you're thinking of the John
I didn't
Belushi
like Christmas with the
Cranks.
Okay, all right. Noel, five New Yorkers come together on Christmas Eve.
Nerland's Noel.
Chaz Belmonte was the director with, don't remember that. Mm-hmm. Barbara Stanwyck with Christmas in Connecticut.
Love it.
Yeah, I agree.
Love
that's
that
a
movie.
Classic.
Never heard of it.
Oh, man.
Perks of Being a Wallflower. Did not know that
was I didn't think that was a Christmas movie.
Okay.
Never heard of it.
It's like a recent teen angst movie.
Oh, like really? Up.
Yeah.
The Christmas is so dumb.
Pretty much. I think that's a direct quote.
Hey, Kimberly.
Christmas Story.
Take your top off.
Christmas Story. Oh, yes. A Christmas Story.
Oh, Christmas Story.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, that's not. That's that low?
Actually, this is...
The remake?
This is Christmas Story, the touching story of how Santa Claus came to be Santa.
Oh wait.
No.
For G-layered.
Yeah. Nativity Story?
No.
Okay. Let's see.
Nobody wants a Christmas movie about Jesus.
Yeah. Hey, you skipped over Shrek the Hall.
Shrek the Hall.
I liked it.
No. Thumbs down.
Oh, wow. All right. How about... I don't remember. Remember the Night with Barbara Stanwyck, 1940. A shoplifter.
Man, lots of Barbara Stanwyck.
Yeah, gets arrested.
She was the hot back then.
Back in the.
No, I'd watch Remember Bob Night.
Black Christmas.
Whoa.
During the Christmas break, a group of sorority girls are stalked by a.
Yeah, that's the horror movie. Yeah,
it's
that
the
counts.
Horror movie.
I've seen that.
Okay. All right. You know what? I will count it.
One Black Christmas.
White Christmas.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
With Bing Crosby.
Black Christmas and
Serendipity.
Christmas. Serendipity.
Oh, yeah, that's the...
With John Cusack.
Kate Beckinsale and John Cusack. She's a nice...
Yeah, I like that movie.
Never saw it.
I like the Cusack.
Okay, yeah, I like Cusack, too. Okay. All right, we have Surviving Christmas, which is Ben Affleck, Christina Applegate, James Gandolfini, an obnoxious young millionaire who plays a family to spend Christmas with him.
Not familiar.
I remember seeing the ads, but I didn't see it because it's
okay.
Astonishing.
Just Friends. When visiting his hometown during Christmas, a man comes face to face with his old high school crush, who had been best friends, a woman whose rejection... No.
Not familiar.
That was my life in the first year of college.
Huh.
Yes.
Just Friends. I don't know.
The classic Bishop's Wife with Cary Grant and Loretta Young.
That is a plus.
I'll defer to the masses.
You should see that one. I think you'd enjoy it. It's...
It is a classic.
Cary Grant has just a touch of magic and...
Yeah.
And
he plays an angel.
And mirth. And he's just... He's a little
about
smarter.
While You Were Sleeping.
The Sandra Bullock movie?
Yes.
Or,
yeah, because it's at Christmas time.
Too much Bill Pullman.
No, not something.
Okay. Independence Day or GTFO for that guy.
Okay, all right. Jingle All the Way is the Arnold Schwarzenegger movie.
Yes, that one counts.
Okay, how about The Ref?
The Ref?
Oh, Dennis. That is greatness.
Dennis Leary,
Kevin Spacey.
Yeah, that's right. Free. Okay, we're going to have to distance now.
Batman Returns.
Which one?
Batman Returns.
Is that the one with
Mr. Freeze, right?
That's Michael Keaton, Demi DeVito. That was the second
Batman. If it's Christmas, does it mean Batman Returns, the gifts he got at the department store?
No, that's the one with Michelle Pfeiffer as Catwoman.
That's Catwoman.
Yeah, that one counts.
Okay.
Christopher Walken is also a bad guy in that one.
Okay, good. Lethal Weapon.
Yes.
That's not a Christmas
movie. It's
not
a Christmas movie.
It's based in Christmas.
No.
It's got more to do with Christmas than Die Hard did.
They're both the same. They don't count.
They're not
it counts
Christmas
to me.
Movies.
Count it.
It's a great
I'm
movie.
Counting.
It's not
you're
a Christmas movie.
You're under direct orders.
Yes. How about Krampus?
Yes. The
bad
horror movie.
Christmas ends up accidentally summing at festive
the demon,
into
yeah.
his family.
What is it?
That's
it's,
Krampus.
It's a, yeah, Krampus. The
okay.
horror movie.
I thought that was Taco. And from the lead, what?
Prancer?
Prancer, yes.
Krampus counts. I don't know about Prancer.
Sam Elliott. Oh, okay.
All right. Gremlins.
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
What?
Gremlins.
Yeah.
It's based on Christmas.
If Randy had a vote, Polar Express would definitely be.
Yeah, Randy's all Polar
yeah,
Express.
Yeah, that one counts.
Okay.
Because it's got Eugene from Grease in it.
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't remember this one. It happened on Fifth Avenue. That is a holiday movie. All right, one that I will push for, The Family Man, with Nicolas Cage and Tia Leone. She looks really good.
Wasn't he like a surly Weatherman or something?
No, he was. This was their, he was,
that was
the version of where
Christmas
he,
Carol. Kind
yeah, he,
no,
Christmas
not Carol,
where he goes. And you know, he goes to another life where
it's like It's a Wonderful Life.
Yeah,
oh, okay.
Yeah, where he goes.
It's
so yeah, I like that one a lot.
That was good. That was good. I will admit. I will.
Grinch Stole Christmas.
Yes.
The Grinch.
Cartoon. Yes, not the movie.
Yes.
Jim Carrey was.
Love Actually.
No,
not familiar.
Oh, I love
that's
that.
That's one with
movie.
Ray Grimes from Walking Dead holding
yes,
all the Bob Dylan signs.
Yeah.
Bob Dylan signs.
All
yeah,
right,
you
so,
know Bob Dylan video where he flips all the cards.
So okay, so no one. I'm the only one who
yeah,
loves that.
Yeah, the only one who wants to love that.
Never
okay,
seen.
All right. Charlie Brown's Christmas?
Yes.
Okay. Shop Around the Corner with James Stewart
yes.
and Margaret Solomon. I agree with you.
Yes.
Not familiar, but
yeah,
I
that's,
if,
that's
if
a classic.
If you saw...
it's You've Got Mail.
Not
it's,
You've Got
Mail.
Was it,
oh,
was it You've Got Mail?
Could be.
Yes, it was.
Yeah,
You've Got
yeah.
Mail. Yes, it was the remake.
All right. Ken Schaefer's favorite Christmas, except I don't think Mr. Magoo on here. His second favorite, Nightmare Before Christmas.
Nightmare Before Christmas?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, with Jack Skellington.
Yes.
Yes.
But isn't that more of a Halloween movie than a Christmas movie?
It's based in Christmas
yeah,
time. He's
Christmas,
taking over for Santa.
Santa Claus, yeah.
Yes.
That's a great movie. That's one
right.
of Arlo's favorite
I know
movies.
You guys will want this one. I just think it's horrible. Bad Santa.
Absolutely. And its sequel, Bad Santa 2.
I didn't see either one of them because I didn't want to see Santa Claus be that one.
Mm-hmm. How's the chick from Gilmore Girls?
Does she, Girls?
She actually needs some work up top.
Joelle Noel, I've not seen it, but that's a film we're based on 1914, where on Christmas Eve, World War I, everyone kind of is together.
Huh.
Not familiar.
Don't remember the movie, so I'm going to go Santa Claus. The
Tim
yes.
Allen?
The Tim Allen?
Yeah.
Most
yeah.
Lots
yeah.
of Tim Allen.
All three of those, yeah.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
We need
more
rating Tim
places.
Allen. Yes,
rating
that counts.
Places. Yes.
See, I don't call it a Christmas movie. Sorry.
Based
the other Jamie Lee Curtis was awesome in it.
Yes.
Brian is whipped by my fate.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No, I think it is. It's set enough in Christmas. All right, Elf.
Oh,
yes.
Yes. Oh, gosh, yes.
Okay, this one I don't think has a Christmas special, but maybe you guys, Edward Scissorhands?
Yes, that's
it was a
Christmas
it was
a
Christmas
scene.
No.
Yeah.
I just had a problem with that. Why would anyone build them with scissors as hands? But, okay.
It's Tim Burton.
Building a
yeah.
barber, yeah.
All right. Scrooged.
Yes.
Yes.
Bill Murray.
Yeah, Bill Murray.
Scrooged. Oh my
that
God.
Final
First
rant where he talks about, you know, with his brother, he's talking to everyone. I just love that final scene. The original Miracle on 34th
yes.
Street.
With Natalie Wood?
Oh,
yes.
Is that the one where she's
yes.
trying to prove Santa Claus exists?
Although
yes.
she's all one more up at that point.
Yeah. yes. All right,
yeah,
so now we're on the... We just hit our top 10. Edward Scissorhands, so Scrooge, Miracle on 4th Street. Home Alone.
Yes.
Yes.
Definitely Christmas-based.
This is
that's
a whip, but I agree it should be on there. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Oh, that's yes. No, that's Christmas.
That's a National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Why is that a whiff? That is a top
just
five.
Just because they are so wheels off.
That's awesome. Yeah.
Now, that movie's great.
I can quote that movie as I watch it.
Now then we're talking about A Christmas Story with Peter Billingsley,
yes.
Darren McGavern.
Yes, that thumbs up.
I have a little interest in the live version they're doing.
Oh, I'm
going to
watch
Saturday.
That, yeah. Most definitely, yes.
All right.
The one with Maya
Rudolph.
Yeah. Rudolph, the Red-Nosed Reindeer, TV movie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, A Christmas Carol. This is the version with Alistair Sims.
All of them.
1951.
Of them. I'm in for all of them.
Okay.
That's
even the Jim Carrey animated one, too?
Yes, I loved it.
And our last two.
I own it.
The library will close in 10 minutes.
Thanks.
I've never seen that one before.
Yeah. What?
The library will close in 10 minutes.
It's the last.
Man, we really shoehorned a lot of movies into a little time frame.
Yes, we did. Well, we did.
It was
yeah.
Rapid line, rapid fire.
Yeah, right, absolutely. The final two, number two, Die Hard.
Absolutely.
Not
first ballot.
Movie, not a Christmas movie.
First ballot.
I'm saying no.
I'm saying yes.
Oh, man. He's the host.
Yes.
Welcome to the party, pal.
And ho, 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 I have a machine gun. And number one, It's a Wonderful Life.
Oh, yes.
First ballot.
Most definitely.
Though I think Miracle on 34th Street is a better Christmas movie than It's a Wonderful Life, but I won't vote against it.
Well, It's a Wonderful Life was not intended to be it wasn't released in the holidays.
Right.
It was released in the summertime.
Yeah.
Yes. A
couple things that didn't make it. Dick Van Dyke did Fritz Willie.
Fritz Willie.
Which is
I just watched it
favorite,
the other night.
Yes,
it was a great movie.
It is one of my favorite movies. The whole idea is this he's the butler of this lady who's lost her fortune. And so he and the whole staff rob to keep her at her.
They let her believe that she's still
rich. Still
rich.
And it's really very
and then Barbara
funny.
Feldon,
yeah,
the great
Barbara
hot
Feldon,
Barbara Feldon comes in.
Plays
in
to be a commoner. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, good stuff.
It's
a
classic
okay.
movie, I love it.
So that was 36.
Wow.
Junior had 30, Scott had 31, Bob had 25, and I had 40.
Overcut me.
Oh. Yeah.
Everybody won
well, you
tonight
were closer
except
than
Junior.
Me.
Huh?
Everybody won tonight except Junior.
Yeah.
You won one, I won one,
I rarely win the showcase showdown in these cases. I think maybe I've won twice.
But you got a double tonight because you hit it on the head.
Me?
Yeah, didn't you get one?
I didn't.
Well, was that you?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, well, I saw.
So, I am so embarrassed, but at the same time, and I watch almost every Hallmark channel.
We do
Christmas
too.
Movies.
My wife and I say about those things.
Yeah.
Hallmark.
Super, super SG.
I know it's SG, but that's fine.
But you know what? I have my things about those.
So we have 5 minutes left. If you can think of it, favorite Christmas present of all time.
Oh, I got that.
Mine is easy.
Okay, go ahead and see Scott.
Fourth grade, my Schwinn Grey Ghost, 5-speed Stingray bicycle.
Yeah.
Shock absorbers on the back, motorcycle drum brakes on the front with a shock absorber on the front as well. Banana seat, got it in the fourth grade. I still own it, and we restored it a couple of years ago, my son and I, and I hang it on my wall in my classroom as art.
Wow, that's cool. Bob, can you remember?
Yeah, it's either going to be the Evel Knievel stunt cycle.
Ooh,
greatness. That was greatness.
Or probably the real winner, the Atari 2600.
That's a close second for me.
Brad Meltzer, you know, the writer, talked about that the year that was coming out, his dad said, I'm telling you right now, Brad, I couldn't find one. They were sold out. And on Christmas morning or Hanukkah, you know, you opened it and there it was. And he's, you know, Brad says, my father's gone now, but this is a shout out to all the parents who lie to their kids around the holiday season.
Well, now was it an intentional misdirection or did he manage to...
No, it was an intentional misdirection. Junior, do you have a memory?
The original Nintendo Entertainment System.
Nintendo?
Yeah.
Atari or GTFO?
No. Atari, I remember getting that as a gift, but I don't know that it was a Christmas gift. So I'm not going to count that one. But even still, even if it was a Christmas gift, the original Nintendo with the robot Rob the Robot. I had that version. And it also came with Duck Hunt. And then I went
what?
Ahead. Duck Hunt. Yes. Mike's brother, Duck Hunt. And I splurged and I bought the Nintendo, original Nintendo version of 10 Yard Fight. So many hours of 10 Yard Fight. It was a magical time for me.
You know what my first video game was?
Pong.
This unit that
was
about
it 18,
version? 20 inches long and probably about 12 inches wide with just two big knobs on it.
Okay,
just go boom, boom,
and,
boom.
I have a couple memories. I can remember getting one of the creepy crawler sets back in the 70s.
Why did you just throw against the wall?
No, this was you. It was this. You did a mold. You poured it.
I had one of those.
You could make bugs.
And the light bulb or whatever, the heating unit would melt them down.
And then when I was really, really young, I had they bought me a full set of the Johnny West action figures. They were the same size as, you know, G.I. Joe's, and you had, Geronimo, and they had all the, you know, the horse, and you had, it was the action figures back then when they were huge.
Man, that's
and, you know, so that was, you know, I think some of mine. So.
Yeah, I think there were several Christmases where I got a new bike, and it's very exciting to get the new bike until you go outside and realize it's December and it's too effing cold to ride a bike. So it's like you have to wait until it warmed up. So that kind of took some of the fun out of it.
Yeah, we bought Chris when he was a junior. We bought him a used car, and he was so excited. And when he went in there and saw that it was a standard. But our famous line was, I said, look, I taught your mom how to drive a standard. I can teach you. And he said, LJ learned how to drive a standard? Okay, no problem. And he, to this day, he's 28, and he is proud of the fact that he can drive a standard, and many of his friends can't.
I tried to learn how one time I put out a clutch.
Yeah. So, thank you guys. Merry Christmas. We hope you get everything you want. Under the tree from Santa. Merry Christmas.
With that reason up there.
God bless us, everyone.